Welcome back, dear students. Under algebra number theory, we are in unit 2, finite fields and polynomials. In lecture 2, we are going to have a look at the roots and degrees of the polynomial. Previously, in lecture 1, we had the introduction of a polynomial and few polynomial kinds. Let's get on to the presentation. So let's move on to the problems. So the first problem, what is the degree of the polynomial f of x is equal to 6x cube plus 5x square plus 3x minus 2 over z6. Okay, if suppose over z6 is not given, you could clearly say that the degree of this polynomial is 3. Good. So how could I say it's 3? The highest degree term, right? The highest that is a variable which has the highest power, that is 3. So then I can call the degree of the polynomial is 3. Now z6 is mentioned here, so there is some restriction. So whenever a modulo set is given, try to write down the elements of that particular modulo set. So how will I represent z6? So I'll have elements starting from 0 to 5, so totally 6 elements, but 6 should not be contained then. Now what do I do? I'll try to check whether this particular polynomial, okay, satisfies over z6. So now let me observe this particular equation. When I look at the given equation, I see that from left side or from right side, I see 2 is there inside the set. So it can be accepted. Let's move on to the next one. 3. 3 is also inside the set. It can be accepted. 5. Is 5 there? Yes, it is. So 5 is also there inside the set, so that can be accepted. But coming over the leading coefficient, that is, the coefficient of the highest degree term. Now that is 6 here. Is 6 over there in the set? It's not there. So what should I do for 6? Then I should divide the 6 over z6. This is what my procedure is. I should see that in a polynomial over a modulo set, the coefficients of those variables necessarily should be the numbers only from the sets, from the set. Okay, so now 6, if I'm going to divide 6 over 6, my remainder is 0. So therefore 0x cube will get vanished. So therefore my resulting polynomial will be 5x square plus 3x plus 4. So now what is the highest degree here? X square is the highest degree. So therefore the degree of the function f of x is equal to 2. Are you able to understand? So over some modulo set is given, try to make sure that all the coefficients of the variables are from that given modulo set. So second problem, find the roots of the polynomial x square minus 2 over the real number r. Now you could see there is no restriction or no modulo set is mentioned here. So just a very simple problem. So x square minus 2 is given. So how do I find the roots of a quadratic equation? So try to equate it to 0 and you get the values. Very, very simple problem. So a polynomial x square minus 2 is given over r. So I have to find the roots of it. So x square minus 2 is equal to 0. So what is x square? X square is equal to 2. So what is x then? X is plus or minus root 2. Therefore the roots are root 2 and minus root 2 in capital R. If we consider the polynomial, it's just a contrast case. If we consider the polynomial x square minus 2 over capital Q, what is Q? Q is a set of rational numbers. Then the roots root 2 minus root 2 do not belong to Q. Not only Q, it does not belong to complex numbers also, right? There is no I here, right? So therefore, I could say that suppose if it is over C, means it is false. It is, does not having any root here. Since it is R, we found the roots and we are written it as R. Now the third problem, determine all the roots of f of x in z6 of x. Now this procedure is quite different. Whereas in the previous problem, there was no modulo set mentioned. So here in this particular problem, modulo set is mentioned here. So what do I do? Whenever I see a modulo set, automatically I will write z6 as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Clear? 6 numbers. So now what do? I will choose only these numbers. and I'll take these numbers and I'll start substituting one by one and see whether my remainder or the value which I'm getting is zero. If it is zero, I can call that particular number or particular element as the root of that particular polynomial, or else if it does not, we are not getting zero as the answer, then we can say it is not a root of f of x. You should use only the numbers from the set. Okay, always remember that. We cannot solve this as we did in the previous problem because here it is clearly mentioned it is in Z6. Now we'll start the problem. So we had written the sets. We had written the elements here. So one by one we'll start substituting. Let's start with 0. So if I'm going to substitute with 0, what will happen? 0 square plus 3 into 0, right? So my answer is 2. Is 2 equal to 0? No, 2 is not equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is not a root. So the value which you have substituted only, you're going to talk. 0 is not a root of f of x. Next, what is the second number? 1. Substitute 1 in this equation. If I substitute 1 in this equation, I'll be getting 1 square plus 3 plus 2. So what is my answer? 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. So my answer is 6. Is 6 accepted as your answer? It cannot be accepted because 6 does not belong to this set. So what do? I divide over 6. That is since the modulo number. So if I'm going to divide 6 over 6, what is my remainder? Remainder is 0. So we write the remainder outside the bracket. So since my remainder is 0, I can say 1 is a root of f of x. Okay, since I substitute 1, I'm getting the remainder as 0. So I can call 1 as a root of f of x. Now the third number. The third number is 2. So let me substitute 2 over here. If I'm going to substitute 2 over here, I'll be getting 2 square is 4 plus 3 into 2 is 6 plus 2. So what is my answer? 12 will be my answer. So if 12 is there, 12 is definitely not accepted here. So if I'm going to divide 12 over the 6, right? My remainder is 0. It's perfectly divisible. 12 is perfectly divisible by 6. So your remainder is 0. So therefore, since my remainder is 0, I can call this 2 as a root of my f of x, my given function. So out of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I had checked for 0, 1, 2. So I found out that 1 and 2 are the roots of f of x. Remember it. Now next, the remaining numbers 3, 4, 5. So if I substitute 3, what will be my answer? I got the answer as 20. So is 20 accepted? Definitely not. So I'm going to divide it over 6. So if I'm going to divide it, perfectly factorizable till 18, right? Till 18 it is there. Remainder is 2. So remainder is 2. Therefore, 3 is not a root of f of x. Now next is number 4. Number 4, if satisfying, my answer is 30. 30. If I'm going to divide it over 6, my remainder is 0, perfectly divisible. So therefore, 4 is a root of f of x. Now, the last number of the set, 5. If I substitute 5, my answer is 42. Is 42 perfectly divisible by 6? Yes, it is. My remainder is 0. Therefore, 5 is a root of f of x. Able to understand? So previously, we had seen 1 and 2 is also a root of f of x. So here we had seen 4 and 5 is also a root of f of x. So therefore, totally, how many roots are there in f of x? The roots of f of x are 1, 2, 4 and 5. So this is under modulo division. Please make it very clear. When a modulo set is mentioned, you have to find out the elements from that particular set and start substituting one by one and find out whether the remainder is 0. If it is 0, you say it's a root. If it is not 0, you say it's not a root. Hope things are clear. So we move on to the next problem. The fourth problem. Find all the roots of f of x is equal to x square plus 4x in Z12. So Z12 means starting number is 0 to 11. So totally 12 numbers. And for 12 numbers, you have to substitute one by one and you have to give the conclusion. So we'll start from 0. If I substitute 0, my answer is 0. Therefore, 0 is a root of f of x. Let me substitute 1. 1, if I substitute, my answer is 5. So 5 is accepted in the set, but it is not equal to 0. So therefore, 1 is not a root of f of x. Then substitute 2. My answer is 12. perfectly divisible, so the remainder is 0. So 2 is a root. Substitute 3. My answer is 21. 21 is not perfectly divisible by 12, right? My remainder is 9. So 3 is not a root. Then substitute 4. My answer is 32. Again, it's not divisible by 12. My remainder is 8 there. So 4 is not a square root of f of x. So out of these 5 roots, what I checked, I see that 0 and 2 alone is satisfying. So the rest of the numbers, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I see that one by one, if I substitute, my answers are greater than 12, I divide it over 12 and I find out the remainder. If the remainder is 0, I can call that particular element as a root, or else it is not a root. Therefore, 6 is a root, 8 is a root. Previously, we had seen 0 and 2 is also roots. Therefore, x is equal to 0, 2, 6, 8 are the roots of f of x over z12. Also, I wanted to insist one thing here. Don't think always for z12, these will be the roots. It depends upon the polynomial. Very good. It depends upon the polynomial. Then only we can say that the roots are satisfies, or the element satisfies the particular polynomial or not. Hope you understood the roots and degrees of the polynomial in this lecture. Thank you so much for watching. Let's continue in the next lecture.